everybody and welcome on my YouTube channel. You are with Alan Dries and today I am on the live server to answer for one question: how to counter Master Mage team. First point, if you think that I will give you one team who will work against every Master Mage, you are mistaken. I will show you one team who is working really well and I will try to explain you the mechanic and the way to think when you are fighting against a Master Mage team. After that, you will have to do your own choice for sure. The first Master Mage that I want to highlight is a version with directional arrows and with a manipulator. It's really important to understand that manipulator will mess the battlefield with a taunt and it will be a big problem for you because most of the time you will receive just after ultimates of Wind Priest and Void Master in all your heroes who are in the same place and you will lose. So what you will do? You will change the direction of the fight. For that, you will use Skeleton Mage. It's really important to understand the mechanic of Skeleton Mage because the mechanic of Skeleton Mage is to summon dragon in the backline of the Master Mage team to receive all ultimates on the backline and not on your heroes. But if you use a normal team with Skeleton Mage, you will kill Master Mage quickly and dragons will be still not on the battlefield and you will lose. So you have to save sometimes and it's interesting to use Rabbit in this situation also. Rabbit is good anyway in all situation against Master Mage teams, but you have 20% of chance to grab Master Mage and to lose. That's why in this situation we will add some chances in our side by adding some heal. We will use Holy Priestess. Holy Priestess in this way will be able, even if you receive some damages, to heal your teams and to give you a chance even if you are not lucky and if you are grabbing Master Mage. After that, we will use as a main tank Cross Knight. Why another time Cross Knight? Because he's far in front lane and he has a taunt and a height survivability. It means if he uses his ultimate, he can receive the ultimate of Void Master and Wind Priest, he will not die. And finally, to finish this team, we will put DPS because we have to kill and we'll put Void Master. Why we choose Void Master? We could choose something else. I will explain you later. But Void Master in this situation will be far in the back lane. So even if you get some ultimates in your face and if you have some heroes who will die in front lane, your Void Master will be out of the fight and he will be able to give a proper DPS for all the team. So let's see the result. I'm level 108 against level 109 and even Witch have a skin, so it's a really strong team, but we will see. So I grabbed Witch. It's not a bad thing. You see, the taunt of a manipulator is really dangerous because now all my team is in front lane and the problem: my dragon will counter the ultimate of Void, it's not a bad point, but I'm receiving the ultimate of Wind Priest on my front lane because of manipulator, and this is really important to understand. Fortunately, I have my Holy Priestess who is helping a lot. She cancels one of my ultimate, okay, and now I'm in a bad situation, but even with this bad situation, because of Holy Priestess, I will be able to win this match. That's why it's really important to have a healer in this team, because when the things are not going like you want, and it happens especially with a manipulator, you are able to save the situation even with a bad grab. In fact, if you are grabbing Master Mage, you are not in bad situation because you will grab Master Mage, you will kill her, you will have a dragon in the backline and the taunt of manipulator will be still not here. And it's really good for you because the ultimate of Wind Priest and ultimate of Void Master will go in the front lane. So, next situation. The second version that I want to introduce is a version with one directional arrow and with sorceress and a lot of heal. To win against this team, you have to understand how you will die. And finally, you can see that you have Sorceress, you can do nothing against her ultimate. You have Lightbringer, you can do nothing against his ultimate. And you have Voidmaster, for him, you can do something against his ultimate. So, we will keep the same strategy than before. We want to turn Master Mage and some DPS, because for sure, Dragons will help even for spell of Sorceress. So, we will use Skeleton Mage and a Rabbit. This is the first. After, we know that we will receive some damage. We can't do nothing against that. So, we will receive the ultimate of Sorceress and probably the ultimate of Lightbringer. So, the only way that we have to save our heroes is to heal ourselves. So, Holy Priestess. After that, we have to manage the heal. And to manage the heal, we have two solutions. We can taunt with a Cross Knight. Cross Knight will help because the taunt is long and during the taunt, enemies can do nothing. And the last hero that I will put this time will be not Voidmaster because his DPS, in my opinion, is not enough strong if we have the heal of Chaplain. So I will use Wind Priest because if Wind Priest is doing his ultimate, even if Chaplain is able to heal, at the end of the ultimate, they will really be not fresh. So we will try and check what's happened. So, first, we have to see what we will grab. Sorceress, but probably she will have time to do her ultimate. So, we have the dragon who will appear behind. We receive the ultimate, like I told. The dragon is behind. Sorceress is die. We have the taunt. The heal, we can do nothing against this heal. It's not a problem. Okay, this is the worst that could happen because Dragon will not do anything because we grabbed Voidmaster in the middle of us. But it's not a problem. We have Holy Priestess who will help. And now, taunt, plus damage. Chaplain is died, and even with this ultimate, we don't care at all, and we won without any problem. I can show you the statistics of the match. For sure, Rabbit did a lot, and Wind Priest did also a lot. Next situation. Next one, Master Mage with a Vanguard Warrior. So, against this team, you have two solutions. The first solution is working well, but be careful, I will explain you why. So, you will use the same strategy, especially because you have Witch and a Wind Priest in front of you. So you will begin with a Rabbit and Skeleton Mage. But be careful, in the beginning of the fight, it will be only 4 targets for Rabbit. So you have a 25% of chance to grab Master Mage and not only 20%. It's 5% more, it's a 1 chance on 4. So for the rest, the strategy is exactly the same. We will put a Cross Knight, we will put a healer because we don't have choice, we will receive some damage of a Sorceress and some damage of a Witch, and we will put finally as last damage dealer, we can change, but this time I want something with a lot of HP because it's a Witch in front, so a damage dealer with more HP than other, it's a Venom Master who is working well. Also, she's dealing a ton of damage when enemies are in the same place. So, let's see the result. So, we are grabbing a Sorceress. So, if we are able to kill her direct, it's amazing, but seems to be not good. We have 3 gingerbread. 1 ultimate, who is not so painful because we have a lot of intellect heroes. We receive the ultimate of Sorceress. And finally, you can see that the dragon with magical immunity is taking a lot of damage. He is missing the ultimate of Wind Priest, so he did the job. Witch did her ultimate. She killed a rabbit with her ultimate. Ultimate of a Skeleton Mage. And finally, it's finished without so much difficulties. Second possibilities that I will show you now is little more difficult to manage against a Vanguard Warrior team, but also really efficient. Against the same team, another situation with working well, it's Working only against a Vanguard Warrior Mastermage team. For the rest, forget about this composition. So, Vengeance Spirit, Avenger, after that, Thunder Beast, Wind Priest, and Venom Master. Crazy Burst team, and the target of this team is to kill directly all heroes that you will have in front, and don't forget that Thunder Beast will stun Vanguard Warrior charge 100% of the time if you have skilled maxed for sure. You will see how it's working. So the fight begins, Master Mage is already nearly died, the Wind Priest is died without any possibility to do something, the stun of a Thunder Beast, even now we will receive some of ultimates in our face. Okay, it's not a problem because we are full life and now we just have to have Vengeance Spirit who shot one time and the fight is over and you can watch statistics of the fight. Wind Priest 0, Master Mage 0 and excepted the ultimate of Sorceress and Witch, you didn't receive nothing and you have enough life to resist. And don't forget that also the ultimate of Avenger, most of the time will disturb the ultimate of Witch because it clones who will receive the damage from the ultimate. The last Master Mage that I will introduce for you today is one of the most difficult to understand because in front of you, you have one team with Magic Breaker who will counter all your Crown Control. You have Musketeer Skin and Sorceress who are not directional heroes who will touch full screen and who will manage your team strongly. And you have a Manipulator who will taunt, who will kill all your ultimate and so on. So, this team is difficult to manage and what we will use? First of all, we will use Rabbit. In this case, it's really important to remove one hero of the fight. After that, we will use something to kill the hero that we have grabbed, and Wind Priest in that way is really strong. We need some heal to survive because the fight will be long. It's not one fight will stay in 2 seconds. So we will use Holy Priestess and Magic Breaker also, because Magic Breaker, if she success to ultimate, she will protect you for most of damages who are magical. And finally, as tank, we will put Cross Knight because Cross Knight will give you a heal regeneration and also is not dealing any damage. It's really good because he will not kill Master Mage quickly. So let's see what we can have with this team. Our situation, we will see first of all what we will grab. Musketeer, so Wind Priest should do the job. Perfect. She's died just before to cast her ultimate. Now we have all our heroes who are fooled. Unfortunately, we killed the Master Mage. So, Manipulator cancelled our ultimate. But we are surviving for the moment. And in the enemy team, it's only Sorceress who will deal a lot of damage. Second ultimate of Manipulator, she cancelled Holy Priestess ultimate and Cross Knight ultimate. Magic Breaker is died, now my Magic Breaker is ultimating. We will receive the ultimate and survive because of the ultimate of Magic Breaker. And finally, all my heroes are alive. And if we are checking damage, 841,000 for Sorceress. We killed Musketeer directly, so it was really good. And you see the ton of control that give Manipulator and Magic Breaker is just insane. So you really have to think in that way to counter this kind of team with Magic Breaker. And then now it's not so usual in War of the God to put Magic Breaker in your Master Mage. If you do a Master Mage team, it's not always the case, but it can happen and you have to know how to counter it. I hope that now you will be able to fight better against Master Mage teams. I want to insist in one point. Counters that I'm giving in this video are not counters who are working 100% of the time in all situations that you can meet, but it gives you the way to think and to counter properly a Master Mage team. Because anyway, I don't think that you can have 100% with one team. You will be close to this percentage and it's already really good. I want also to thanks a lot Nazgul who helped me for this video because he gave me one of the Master Mage counter that he's using and this counter is working really well. Last point. If you want to comment with your own counter with working well, you can also help the community. So, don't forget to like the video and to subscribe to my channel if you still didn't do it. It's all for today. It's now time to conclude. Thank you everybody for watching this video. Don't hesitate to subscribe, like and share to support my work if you enjoy it. See you soon for another video. Bye bye.